Do you want me to comment on I have some material on the Turkish Russian conference in St. Petersburg. It's not more than 2 or 3 minutes. Do you want me to expand on that in correlation to what we talked about? Because I think it also, yeah, it pertains to Iran as well. We had the President Recep Tayyip Erdogan visit St. Petersburg recently and met with President Putin. And not to around the same time, we had a meeting, a very important meeting between President Putin in Baku, Azerbaijan, with Ilham Aliyev, President of Azerbaijan, and Iranian President Hassan Rouhani. I think that was to send a signal to the Turks, to not feel too confident, by the way. But I believe the St. Petersburg meeting was about assisting in the stabilization of the Turkish regime by Moscow. And such stabilization, of course, would be a hard bargain for Russia. The Turks have realized how beneficial a Turkish withdrawal from the American influence and its reorientation toward Moscow actually is. And I think Ankara also understands that for Russia, the threat of destabilization or even the disintegration of Turkey is a significant threat. Therefore, even with their weak negotiation position, the argument for a major trade, are there as far as what's beneficial to Turkey and what's beneficial for Russia. I think Russia ultimately wants to, at some point, when Turkey has paid for its sins, in supporting ISIS and in being on the wrong side of the history, and being on the side of Washington, NATO, and Saudi and Qataris, at some point, I think the Russians would be interested in including Turkey into their new geopolitical arrangement and taking Turkey away from NATO. I think the Iranians welcome this in a sense that I think they are hopeful that the Turks are paying, are sort of, what's the right word I'm looking for? They're confessing their sins, if you may say, in having been on the wrong side, and they want to be on the right side. But I think the Turks, being the shrewd politicians that they are, they have realized that in the Muslim world, they have really lost their credibility because of their support for ISIS. You have to keep in mind that the Muslim world is very awake and alert, and are into all sorts of conspiracy theories that are otherwise not entertaining the Western world, for example. So the Muslim world has realized that the Turks have lost their soft power because they have been supporting these ISIS savages. And so the Turks are cognizant of that, and they're trying to repolish their image. Because the Turks and the Iranians have always been in a competition over the ideological leadership of the Muslim world. And I remember when Erdogan came into power, along with at that time the president was I believe was Abdullah Gül. These two were causing quite a what's the right word I want to use? Quite a revolution in the Islamic world, in a sense that they were taking Turkey away from a strong westernized sort of the Ataturk-oriented pro-army, pro-NATO affiliation into more of an Eastern alliance with the Muslim world. So the Muslim world was very enthusiastic about this, and so were the Iranians. But as time proved, especially with the creation of ISIS and the Turkey's role, they lost that soft power. So I think with Turkey sort of making all these gestures of wanting to be close to Russia, there may be some credibility issues there, because I think Turkey is very the cognizant of its lost image in the Muslim world. So it's trying to polish that. And in some ways, it may try to attempt to create some rift between the Russo-Iranian relationship. I think this is what the Iranians are suspicious of that. But the Iranians are counting on their time cherished and the long alliance with the Russians, and they're hoping that everybody could be on the right side instead of having to compete for the Russian attention.